Okay, here we'll prove the Heron's formula, and here we go. First, let's begin with the triangle, and let me just draw it right here. And I will call this to be A, B, and C. And remember, the area of the triangle is just going to be 1/2 base times height. And let me take this for the base, and I will just say here is going to be the height. And let's say this is B1, and here is B2. Now, here's the deal. The area is 1/2 base times height. H. If we can write H in terms of A, B, and C, then we will be in good shape. So that's the key, right? Let's see. Let me just write down the things that we can do from this picture first. For example, we know B1 plus B2 has to be just equal to B. So let me just write that down. And if we look at this triangle, this is the right triangle, so we can actually just use the Pythagorean theorem for this. So let me write down B1 squared plus h squared, that's equal to a squared. And similarly, we can do the same thing right here. So b2 squared plus h squared, and that has to be equal to c squared. So that's pretty good as well. Let's see. Let's go ahead and just work with these two equations first, because as we can see, they both have the h squared. So let me just look at these two, and then let's subtract the equations. When we do that, this and that will be cancelled it, and this is going to be b1 squared minus b2 squared, that's equal to a squared minus c squared. That's pretty good. And notice this is the difference of two squares, so of course we can factor it, b1 minus b2 times b1 plus b2, like this, and that's equal to a squared minus c squared. I am not factoring out the right-hand side because we notice the left-hand side here, this right here is nicely equal to just the b, right? And let's divide the b on both sides. So in another word, we can see that b1 minus b2 is nicely equal to a squared minus c squared all over b. And you can see that the right-hand side is just in terms of a, b, and c, which is pretty good. And we can make it better, because if you look back to this equation, we have b1 plus b2 is equal to b. Let me just put that down. And I am just going to add the equations, because this way, we can actually get rid of the b2, right? This and that will be cancelled it. So let's work with this first. Well, let's get the common denominator. So this right here should be over b, and I need to multiply by another b. So this is b squared plus this and that. Let me write it as a squared plus b squared, and then minus c squared over b. Okay, now the left-hand side, b1 plus b1, just 2b1. Let me divide the 2 on both sides. So I get b1 equals this over 2b, like that, yeah? So that's what we have for b1. And perhaps we can write it down right here, just for some notes. Okay, I have b1. But I still need to find h. What's the connection between b1, h, and a? Well, it was right here, right? So if you look back here, we can subtract the b1 on both sides. In another word, h squared equals a squared minus b1 squared. And of course, we can just take the square roots on both sides. Of course, just do it with the positive square root, because we are doing geometry. So h is equal to this right here. So that's pretty good. And I'm going to write that down right here for you guys as well. So h is nicely equal to square root of a squared minus b1 squared. That's good. And you see, b1 is in terms of a, b, and c. I can just put that down right here. And that's pretty much the idea, right? So let me clean things up right here, and I will do the next part. So now here is the deal. The area of a triangle, of course, is equal to 1/2 times base times height. And of course, we have seen that earlier, h is equal to this. So we'll just open a square root. And inside here, we have a square minus b1 square. And we know b1 is equal to this. And that's so nice, because b1 is in terms of a, b, and c. And now we can just write that down. And now, this formula is actually so nice, because the area of a triangle is already in terms of a, b, and c, right? However, this is not how the Heron's formula looks like. So I will do some more algebra for you guys in order to get to the form that we want, right? Okay, we can combine fractions inside. Notice on the bottom here is 2b, and then we have to square that, meaning that we actually have 4b squared. So for this, I will have to multiply the bottom and the top by 4b squared, so they will have the same denominator. So that's pretty good. And let me just continue. Let's have the 1 over 2b all the way in the front, and then the square root. Both of them will have the 1 over 4b squared, so I will just write that down first. 1 over 4b squared. And then, notice that for this part, is 4a squared b squared, and a minus, this is something squared. I think it's a good idea to write this as parentheses with 2ab inside, and then square, and then minus, for this, I will keep it a squared plus b squared minus c squared, and then square. Because this way, we can actually use the difference of two squares to factor out inside, right? Which is very nice. Now, you notice that we have the 1 over 2b in the front, huh? Let's invite them inside of the square root house. And when you do that, be careful though. 1 over 2 inside of the square root becomes 1 over 4. And then the b on the outside, inside becomes b squared, right? So, as we can see, everything will be inside. And 1 over 4 times 1 over 4, that's 1 over 16. B squared and over b squared, they cancel out. And now we can focus on this. Factor it out with the difference of two squares. Notice here is the first term, and this is the second term. Now, let's go ahead and continue. Parentheses minus another parentheses. That's the first factor. And then another factor is parentheses plus the second parentheses. Well, what's inside of the parentheses? Of course, that's just doing everything. Very nice, huh? Now, the question is, can we do more? Of course. Notice for this part though, if you distribute the negative from here to here, you will notice that we actually get c squared first, right? And then if you distribute, you actually end up with minus, and then we get a squared, and then minus b squared, right? And this right here is a plus 2ab, like so. This is the perfect square, which is very nice, okay? And for this part though, if you focus on 2ab and also this, well, that's also a perfect square. Let me write it down first. We will keep it as a squared plus 2ab and then plus b squared. And in the end here, we have the minus c squared. So that's the idea. And now if we look back to this, in fact, we can factor more because here is c squared and I can factor on negative first. If we do that, here it becomes a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. In another word, that's a minus b and a square. Very nice, huh? And then here, we can of course factor the first three terms. It's a plus b squared and then minus c squared. This is the difference of two squares, and of course this is also the same thing, right? So, I think now it's a good time for me to write down the square root again. Let me not put down the 1 over 16 yet. Let me just look at this and then factor it for you guys. Right here, we will have c minus this and then c plus that, right? And then for this right here, of course, we can do the same thing. Now, here is the time to take care of the 16. And notice that we happen to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 factors. And 16 is precisely 2 to the 4th power, right? So I will write down the 16 as this right here over 2, and then over 2, and then right here, and then right here. Very nice. Now, here we have a plus b plus c over 2. I'm going to call that to be s. So let me just write that down. Let a plus b plus c over 2 to be s. And this right here, it's what we call the semi-parameter. Because a plus b plus c is the parameter of a triangle. And divided by 2 is, of course, the semi-version of it. Very nice, right? This right here is s. How about this, though? Well, it's actually really nice as well. If we have a plus b minus c over 2, this right here, have a look. In fact, it's the same as saying a plus b plus c over 2, and we just have to minus c. And you see this right here works because, of course, to get a common denominator, I need a 2 and a 2. C minus 2c is precisely the negative c, which is very nice, right? And the rest can be done with the same way, so I'll let you guys verify that yourself. Finally, I will tell you, this right here is s. And then, next, we have the s minus c, and you can imagine we have s minus b, and this right here is s minus a, so all we have to do is just write that down. So, ladies and gentlemen, this right here is the Heron's formula for the area of a triangle, and this is a proof, so I will draw a box and shade this in.